July 3rd crop update. Look at them beans. This is July 3rd. I will try and find, I don't know if I was making videos last year. It'd be fun. I'll look through my videos and see what I had for a July, early July corn and soybean video and see if I can't bring them back up. But yeah, I mean, look at, we're doing really good. I don't know if this is quite average for the area. There are a lot of fields that the beans are smaller, and there's some fields that the beans are bigger. So this is just slightly better than average, let's say. Just slightly better than average of the area. But it's a good representation of what our area is looking like this summer. This is fantastic. We got rain for the week. We had a couple scattered tents. And then we got 2 inches the other day. What was the other day? Sunday. Sunday morning. We got 2 inches, or like 1.7 something. Sunday morning, just a great big rain. It wasn't an absolute downpour, but, you know, 2 inches in less than 12 hours, I consider it a pretty heavy rain. And right now, we've got a couple tenths already this morning. And it looks like we might end up with another tenth or two by the time this blows out over the next 3 or 4 hours. So we are sitting very well on moisture. We are, I would say 20, almost 30%. I would say we're getting close to 30% ahead of our normal schedule for growing degree units, on the corn. And that also relates to the soybeans, is if we're that far ahead on heat, we've already had that much extra sunlight. Soybeans respond to sunlight better than they do to heat. Corn, if it's a hot, cloudy day, corn's going to still keep growing. Beans, if it's a sunny, cooler day, beans will still respond to the sunlight and keep going. Where if it's cool, if it's cloudy and warm for a period of time with some cool overnights, you'll see beans yellow out real quick. But soybeans, so far soybeans are looking fantastic. I have nothing to complain about other than I have volunteer corn in a field that has never seen a corn field in my memorable life. I think it would have been the late 80s for the last time this farm has had corn on it. So the stupid birds doing their flyover pooping or whatever. Yes, so soybeans, have no complaints, even the tiny beans. The no-till sod field right over here, that sod, there's something about no-till sod. There's something going on in that sod I'd like to do more research and digging with. Them beans are quite a bit smaller. It'd be more looking kind of like this little, how it thins out right there. They'd be more looking like that. But they look just like that. They're smaller, but it's still green, healthy, going good. You can still see growth going on. It's just a little bit slower growth. Otherwise, the soybeans and the corn stalks, they are way farther farther than these. They look tremendously huge compared to this. No complaints on soybeans for the year, other than the markets are really crashing bad. All right, let's check the other crops. The oats and soybeans. So that, you know, I slipped my way up here without trying to knock anything down. The oats are really tall here, and it's just a super thick cluster. Looking back, you can see how it dips down and then gets tall again. So this is a thick spot, and the soybeans get tall. The soybeans are really looking good out here. This is really kind of cool. The other thing is it's raining right now, but during a normal hot day, you can come out here. And same thing in the pasture, is it is just teeming with bugs. There are, all you see is dragonflies, butterflies, bees, moths, just a ton of life floating around the top of the canopy. And when you get down inside, there is tons of toads and spiders, and on the ground it's just loaded with millipedes and centipedes and beetles and all these other bugs. And you see some random leaf damage, you know, a bug, a random grasshopper or whatever has eaten a hole in a leaf. But all around me right here, there's one there, couple there, and a couple there, So all around me, for all I see, for the amount of bug life that I see extremely little soybean plant damage. So that's kind of cool. I suppose all that bug life, a lot of that life is bugs eating bugs and not bugs eating plants. But yeah, they're, I cannot see much for water hemp, pigweed, ragweed, them types of noxious weeds coming up through. So there's one ragweed. I can live with that. You can live with some random noxious weeds. I can't live with a infestation of them. I see nothing saying that the field is any worse off for weeds than any other field. This is really cool. I am loving this. And these soybeans are knee high. Let me get in here so I can show you that that's my knee. There's the plant right there. I am kind of a taller person, so to say that these beans are knee high to me, but yet where the oats get thin, the beans then are shorter. They're a little bushier and thicker. I am kind of getting more and more excited for this every day, because this is as good of an oat field. It does not look as good as my pasture mix. My pasture mix, you'll see it. I mean, them oats is just, it is just oats. Perfectly level, like you machined it. I mean, it is so even. Here you can kind of see some wheel tracks and you see some missing stuff where the soybeans are really coming through. But overall, this is a fantastic looking oat crop. We're driving around after the cattle auction. Took some back roads to check our own fields and then just continued on some back roads to make our way around home. And compared to some neighbors that planted oats, this oats looks just as good. I think this is super cool. I seeing that the soybeans are growing now, I am getting more optimistic every day. You know, 2 weeks ago, the beans were quite a different look, and they were a lot more yellow. They were a lot thinner. And you're just like, man, they're not really going to make it. The oats were sucking all their nitrogen. But look at the... look at the grain, all the seeds that are there. Man, that has to, look at that, just a cluster of seeds. This is gonna be so fun to combine and see. I at this point, I would have a very hard time to not believe I'm gonna be over 50 bushel on oats. But keep in mind, this is a field that is historically 25 to 30 bushel beans. And if we get 50 bushel oats at $2, that's $100 an acre, that's 10 bushel. So if the beans come behind at 20 bushel, that would be the same revenue as 30 bushel beans. But if the beans come behind at 30 bushel, that is the same revenue as 40 bushel, and we just keep counting up the ladder. So we already got our first, in theory, we might have our first 10 bushels of beans right here. But what if the oats do better? If the oats do worse, we're still out nothing because they weren't even intended to be here. So that's the funny part. But if the oats do 60, 70, 80 bushel, which is not uncommon for our area, man, I think that is super cool. I'm just loving this. I'm loving this more and more. This is going to be what my soybeans fields kind of look like from now on, I think. So, all right, let's go look at corn. All right, our corn update. I guess I have no complaints this year for corn. Like I said, just like soybeans, I'll have to go back in the videos and see if I can't see a July corn from last year, July 4th type of thing. We got two updates to do. We got corn and the cover crop in the corn. Let's start there. Let's get down here. You can see a random little something. There's a radish already. I guarantee that's a radish. The day after I seeded, we got
all that rain. We got like a tenth of an inch that day, and we got, did we get a couple inches since then? Yeah, and here's a bunch more little guys coming. That is just so awesome. It is so awesome. Don't know what this is, but hopefully it's something I intended to be here. There's a little guy right inside their corn rut. How awesome. He's going to be just massive. He's going to be massive. Now, here's the thing, guys. Everybody says, well, aren't you worried about competition? No, I am not. Because if corn is putting in our soil here, if corn is putting roots down 3, 4, 5 feet, you would have to really fight me to the death to tell me corn isn't getting down little tiny hair roots for nutrients down at 4 and 5 feet. I would not believe you, and we go get a backhoe and we'll dig a pit to prove me right or you wrong, or me wrong and you right. But yeah, so I do not worry about that, because look at the canopy here. It's not going to be too much longer, and this is about as bright as it's going to be. So this stuff's going to get germinated. I hope it gets germinated. I hope it starts doing something, but it isn't going to do a whole lot until later on this fall, summer, you know, when the corn starts losing leaves. So yeah, super cool. The cover crop in the corn is doing good. Yep. So it's only been, I don't know, we'll have to go back in the videos. It is starting to rain. Two things. One, we got some bears in the area, so when I move through the cornfield now, I have to clap my hands because we got a massive boar black bear. So I'm kind of nervous about that. I don't want to walk up onto him because he's in this area a lot. And then the other thing is, let me change this camera view quick here so I can get... The other thing is this. There's corn, people. There's corn. Lord. That is pretty stinking cool. I think that says okay, corn report done. Obviously not every spot looks like this. Our last planted stuff at the end of May, that stuff is still, even that stuff is ahead of schedule. That stuff is already knee high as of a couple days ago, and I think yeah, with some sunlight later on, by the end of the week, that stuff's going to be waist high. This is just absolutely fantastic, fun, fantastic. It ain't in the bin yet, but at least we're having fun up until this point. We've had, since 2011, we have had a lot of heartbreak on our crops. And so, you know, over the last 7 years, we haven't had 1 year. Well, 2015 was the 1 year where you're just like, yeah, out of seven. So we need another one. We're entitled to another one. This is really, really fun. I am gonna get out of here because it is really starting to rain. So there's the corn and the corn cover crops.